I'm Madison. I'm a junior at Rockwell High School. The name of a best friend is someone who walks with you every mile and listens to you steadily. It started 3 years ago. October 17th, 2014, the day was implanted in my mind like I could reach out and touch it. While standing in line, I caught the twinkle of his blue eyes staring at me just from the way. It was a question. But within seconds of telling my feet, it flashed me how it was before even asking my name. 6 months later, I was finally able to call him my best friend, and the word stuck so easily like it was the perfect match of a puppy. He taught me how to speak. I can still remember the way his hands held my waist as I tripped over my wheels, and instead of face planting, he spun me and landed on his back, leaving me comfortable. He told me it was okay to cry, that it was okay to be okay, okay to be myself. He told me he was proud when I didn't even know what he was proud of. My best friend that has held my hand in every obstacle I faced, who might slip me during my elbow, who let me step on his feet at my first dance, and who is very well that in my father's message. My best friend told me he believed in me and I didn't even know how to get out of bed. He woke up at 5 a.m. every morning and drove 20 miles to make sure my sisters and I were okay and had a ride to school. My best friend told me I was beautiful and I felt sick and woke up. He gave me my stuff lying because he couldn't even hold me when I called him if I could sleep at night. My best friend has proved to me that hugs and kisses aren't the only things that can comfort me. He has a strong heart because even in his weakest moments, he still attempts to be there for me and smile each and every day. When he bows his head and tries to hide his pain, I see that when I'm upset, it reflects on him, but he won't admit that his mood is reflected by me. When he's standing by the bathroom, I try to find the courage to smile and tell him that I'm okay. I've wanted nothing but for him to be happy, and when I ask him what else I can do, he says, you always say do that. Whether it be a text, a call, we could be arguing, or the closest of friends, but you're always going to be the same as a friend. March 26, 2018, we both carry our present suitcase to show that we'll never be far apart. My best friend doesn't push me as an injury, so doesn't realize he pushed into my back, and he doesn't realize how much I love him.